Hello, Samson Mills. Usually when we do our annual meeting, we do it together in person, but like everything in COVID style, we're doing it virtually. So this gives us some pluses and minuses. The plus is today's annual report by your pastor and about the state of Samson Mills and what we anticipate for the future is gonna be through a video format. But I promise you, it's not gonna just be me talking. We're gonna see some images about what happened in this year that's been, as we have been saying, unprecedented, right? But as we do so, I hope it is a place, a time of reflection, because we certainly could imagine a year ago when those first cases reached the headlines. We could never imagine how something halfway around the world would totally affect us and upend our lives in such profound ways. How one city in lockdown would be a foreshadowing of the lockdowns that we would experience ourselves. Back in March of 2020, each day brought with it a startling new reality that we would have to face. It felt like at times we were all grasping a rope that was constantly being pulled away from us. And each day required us to pivot. We had to pivot to increase sanitation. We had to adapt to masks. We had to grapple with lockdowns and what that meant. We learned how to do school at home. Our work at the church faced similar hurdles too, inviting us to become agile in meeting our ministry and mission goals that have remained constant even in this unprecedented year and time that we have experienced. And that mission here at Samson Mills is simple. It's threefold: to love and serve Jesus Christ, to cultivate community, and to empower our neighbors. Now, I gotta tell you, when this all started, it wasn't as if I wasn't quaking in my boots when the world came to a halt and our country was gripped by the pandemic. We all wondered questions like, how do you do church when you can't come together physically in the building or the sanctuary? How do we fully fund our ministry budget when offerings will have to be collected differently? How will we do children's ministry, pray with others, visit folks in the hospital, mourn with our loved ones, celebrate the joys, feed our neighbors, care for our community, now that we were distant and apart together? While Samson Mills, your faithfulness matched with God's generosity has proven that we could still be the church. We've had lots of ways to celebrate and give thanks for that as we switched gears and found creative ways to meet our vision and be the kind of church that God calls us to be and that our community needed. We shifted all of our ministry online from worship to Bible study to children's ministry. We worked at maintaining our connections through weekly worship packets, senior porch lunch visits, phone calls, and Zoom meetings, and Zoom meetings, and Zoom meetings, and by incorporating home videos of liturgy and song in our weekly worship. We called new officers to serve the church, and we welcomed 6 young people with their professions of faith through confirmation. We exceeded our giving estimates for this year, and that meant that we could meet our mission commitments to partners like the Blessing Board, Salvation Army, Intersection, Sunshine Kitchen, and Presbyterian Disaster Assistance, as well as all of our own ministry needs here. We renovated our building even in this year to become more COVID-friendly, but also as an investment for our future with new sanctuary technology and a welcoming new narthex that someday soon, we know, will become a fellowship center. We stepped up in new ways of being for our community too, by turning our parking lot into a pop-up movie night, a back-to-school blessing bash to equip our students with masks and needed homework kits, an Advent workshop to help families keep Advent at home. We turned our front yard into a pumpkin patch and a maze for families to come safely to celebrate the fall season. We celebrated Easter and Christmas, utilizing the diverse gifts of our congregation. We were able to have a Holy Week and even a pageant, a children's pageant at Christmas. We converted our food bank for the last 10 months as a drive-through service. And every time we worried that there wasn't gonna be enough volunteers, somehow there was always enough. In fact, we learned that when we thought there wasn't enough, we discovered that there always was. Enough faith, enough grace, enough generosity. Because with God, there's always enough. This has been especially true when things got hard and heartbreaking along the way, for there have been plenty of those moments too. Sure, there was a lot of things we couldn't do, but working in the space of enough, we learned what really matters and pursued this with creativity, passion, and intentionality. Now, as we move into this new year, we will carry with us all of the hard, that's for certain, from the last year, but also all the hope too. Why? Because I am hopeful to believe that there is always enough light, that there is light. Belonging to Jesus tells me this is so. Now, as we move into this post-pandemic world, our ministry will seek to honor this pause as we retool for the future. We are thankful to lean into a hybrid approach for our gatherings, a mix of in-person worship and online opportunities. We look forward to launching churchwide mission projects. We anticipate bringing back Food Truck Fridays and the flea market this summer. We will bring with us into the future these pop-up ministry events like movie nights in the parking lot and soon an Easter family activity also to be held in the parking lot. We are also eagerly preparing for Vacation Bible School, but a little bit different. We are reimagining our week-long program as an outdoor park experience, perhaps partnering with other churches. Way back last spring of 2020, our slogan was, "The church left the building." Sure, it was a cheeky way of meeting our reality head on. But it was an affirmation that we have always really known. It's not the steeple, but it's the people that make a church. It is us, you and me together, that make us the church, this church here at Sampson Mills.
I am the church.
You are the church.
We are the church together.
All who follow Jesus.
All around the world.
Yes, we are the church together.
The church is not a building.
The church is not a steeple.
The church is not a resting place.
The church is a people.
I am the church.
You are the church.
We are the church together.
All who follow Jesus.
All around the world.
Yes, we are the church together.
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 Yes, we're the church together.
We are indeed the church together. We will need to be the church together as we move also into a post-pandemic world and into the future that God is calling us to go and to be the church in as well. Are you ready? Let us be the church together.